For me in Australia, the campfire was almost a sacred thing. You know, that's when everybody is brought down to the same level. I think it'd be a terrible shame if that tradition is ever lost, because I think every Australian kid should have sometime in their lives know that experience. And I would imagine once they've had that experience, they'll always want to get back to it.
I've got everything but nothing without you.
My wife, Mary Kay, was born northwest New South Wales in Gundawindi Hospital, but very soon taken back out to Sefton. That was the name of her dad's place, her dad and mum's place. She was one of six, good Catholic family, very isolated, and so much so that they were often did correspondence out there, and when strangers came to the house, they'd all hide under the house or under their mum's dress, and so they were a very shy family, and a dad who's not with us anymore, George, who was a fantastic bloke, they called Old Pancho behind his back because he looked a bit like a Mexican, but he hit the Scotch pretty well when he was first came back from war, because it was a soldier settlers block. So Mary Kay doesn't have real fond memories of her early days, and she sort of shivers when you take her back there, really. And so over the years I've heard this story. I guess she got away from it by the fact they sent her to boarding school at a pretty young age, and to the coast, where she was looked after by a spinster aunties on the coast. But I guess the song tells the rest of the story, really.
Perfectly pretty, perfectly shy, little girl from the dry land, wondering why there's no trees on the south side to stop that howling wind. Little girl from the dry land, honey, the creaky weatherboards painted the milky green, keeping that scary world outside. It's banging on the windows, blowing the washing off the line, calling out for that little girl on the dry land. Two older brothers, sister and you, one little nipper, another one Jew, hiding under the homestead when strangers come along, father out on the wheat field. Honey, the creaky weatherboards painted the milky green, keeping that scary world outside. Banging on the windows, blowing the washing off the line, calling out for that little girl on the dry land. You hide the whiskey, but then what for? Your father is awake to you. You are protector, and your mother always knew. You wondered why you were born out on a wheat field. You know there is much more to life than sky and endless plain. Your father told you stories of the war, of Singapore and Paris, and oh, how you long to go. But you are young and stuck out on the dry land. And only the creaky weatherboards painted the milky green, keeping that scary world outside. It's banging on the windows, blowing the washing off the line, calling out for that little girl on the dry land. Calling out for that little girl on the dry land. Calling out for that little girl on the dry land.
Chandelier stars, that I've had that title in my head for years. When I used to drive tractors, just before the sun was coming up at night, if I was driving all night on a night shift, there was only a few stars left. You know, Venus was always the last one to go. But they just seemed to be that real at that point of the night. You could almost grab them, you know. It was like they were hanging close to you. In fact, one night I was that spooked by Venus. I thought it was a UFO following me around. It was that big and large and, you know. But the song itself was inspired by a very ordinary night we had in Derby, actually. And I wasn't all that impressed with the accommodation, and neither was the crew, or the venue, which I won't name. It turned out pretty good in the finish, but during that day I was thinking, you know, God, I'm going backwards here, you know, like, I've been spoiled a bit singing in nice theatres, and here we were in a pretty ordinary pub. And I guess that's when you start to feel lonely I'm starting to feel missing Mary Kay. And it all came to there, you know, I've got everything but nothing without her, you know. So, and I played it to the crew and everybody related to it. They were all feeling a bit the same way, I think. It's nice that it ended up the title of the album.
When my traveling days are done, will you still be with me when all the songs have been sung? Standing right beside me, watching the grandkids grow, I've got everything but nothing without you. I've got mountains, I've got rivers, got a chandelier of stars, got blossoms on the bloodwood, friends all around the country, and a heart as good as new. I've got everything but nothing without you. Too much time for thinking, it's gonna drive me mad. I walk along the river, I watch a motel movie, but lovers make me sad. I've got everything but nothing without you. I've got mountains, I got rivers, got a chandelier of stars, I've got blossoms on the bloodwoods, got friends all around the country, and a heart as good as new. I've got everything but nothing without you. When this life that binds me turns me loose, lets me rest on my laurels, will you put your head on my shoulder and share the peaceful years? I've got everything but nothing without you. I've got mountains, I've got rivers, got a chandelier of stars, got blossoms on the bloodwood, friends all around the country, and a heart as good as new. I've got everything but nothing without you. I've got mountains, I got rivers, got a chandelier of stars, got blossoms on the bloodwoods. Friends friends all round the country and a heart as good as new. I've got everything but nothing without you. I've got everything but nothing without you.
I think we've reached a stage in Australian country music where we're at the crossroads, because we've lost virtually the founding members of our industry. You know, we've lost Buddy Williams, Tex Morton, Slim Dusty, of course, all the great legends. People like Barry Thornton, the guitarist, Thel out of the partnership of Rick and Thel. So many people, Shirley Toms, And I've seen a tendency over the years for young people to listen a lot to the American style of music, and I think in a lot of ways they've gone very rock and rolly, you know. The Australian country music through those legends has really been our folk music. It's if you read into the lyrics that have been written all the way from Banjo Paterson through the country singers, it really, there is a whole lot of history of the Australian bush. And that to me is what kids should be listening to. They can go all sorts of directions afterwards, but I think they've got to keep their well in contact with the roots of our country music industry, and not just for music industry, but for Australia itself. It's the old saying, if you don't take care of your roots, the tree will fall over. And I've seen that happen in the rock industry, I think, and perhaps even in the country music in America. I don't know that they're still well connected with where it all came from, you know. I might be wrong there, but Bells in a Bushman's Ear is really devoted to that kind of music and to those people that I mentioned, and to people like Bill Sullivan, who's a real Bushman, and the kind of thing that I know they like to hear, the kind of words that Slim used to sing, you know, that are really have come out of the bush itself. And the simple life of living in the bush, and the things that are important to people in the bush. Then it's not sports cars and fashion and all that sort of stuff, you know.
Don't knock the old hillbillies, people love them out in the bush. A simple tune with words that you can hear. You don't need complications where hearts are kind and true. Just words that ring like bells in a bushman's ear. Maybe you need to stroll down a little dirt track, slow down and walk in time with the drover. Hear the wind play a tune on the cypress pine. You don't need beer and you don't need wine. Just words that ring like bells in the bushman's ear. Like the hovering kite that whistles, telephone wires that hum, and thunderstorms that rumble loud and clear. Smells the rain that's coming, hear the cocky screech and yell. Words that ring like bells in a bushman's ear. Maybe you need to stroll down a little dirt track, slow down and walk in time with a drover. Rattle an enamel mug with a spoon, talk to your dog or talk to the moon. With words that ring like bells in a bushman's ear. Yeah, rattle an enamel mug with a spoon, throw him a bone and make him swoon. Words that ring like bells in a bushman's ear. No, don't knock the old hillbillies, people love them out in the bush. Campfire is no place for rock and roll. The proof is in the pudding, they don't come and go. Images embedded in your soul. Maybe you need to stroll down a little dirt track, slow down and walk in time with a drover. And when it rains you run amok, dance on the back of a cattle truck. Yeah, words that ring like bells in a bush. Swimming inside a tin, mutton chops that grease your chin. Yeah, words that ring like bells in a bushman's ear.
It's always great to talk to old rovers. You know, I've met some beauties over the years, but I think Bill Sullivan has to be one of the most impressive. And the reason being that I've seen, as I have with others, but especially Bill, I've seen this great connection with the black stockman. And when he speaks in Arrernte or Walpiri, and he speaks other languages apparently too, Pitjantjatjara, it just amazes me how his whole body seems to change. He actually does become one of them, you know. And I guess that's what happened with him, spending so much time on the road around the campfire, on the Burrsville track or wherever, with these people. But Bill Sullivan, you know, in his own way, to me, he's a legend, you know. And I'm so pleased that I was able to bring him into a song.
Bindi waro waro enaya barala namal bindayano nal binde waro waro naya barala namal bindayano naya barala namal bindayano.
Tell me, old Bill Sullivan, when you were a lad, did you hear of murder and ways? You speak a little Arrernte, Walpiri, but you'd rather speak of droven days. Hard to imagine, not so long ago, Aborigines weren't allowed to come to town, but pioneer picture night, oh boy, what a treat. They broke the rules and let them watch the cowboys. Gene Autry, Tom Mix, yoo-hoo, here they come, chasing all the Indians away. Shoot 'em down, round 'em up, yoo-hoo, for the cowboys. But what about the Indians? Those brave native Indians. Do we love those cowboys? Up in the saddle, black men by your side, they knew the nomad days were done. Proud to be ringers, perfect for the job, in the hot and dry and dusty run. Big hats, red shirts, hear the jingle jangle, this is how the West was won. Now down on the riverbed, nothing left to do, now the droving days are done. Gene Autry, Tom Mix, yoo-hoo, here they come, chasing all the Indians away. Shoot 'em down, round 'em up, yoo-hoo, for the cowboys. What about the Indians? Those brave native Indians. Do we love those cowboys today?
I think one of the reasons I believe that Waltzing Matilda will always be our greatest song is that it's based around the campfire, and to me that's when everybody is brought down to the same level, whether you're a millionaire or a swaggy or whatever. And it takes us right back to our very beginnings, you know, like there's nothing more primeval, I suppose, or primal than to going back to the campfire. It's the same thing that the very earliest man did, you know, and when you study the campfire, I think you study your own mind, and it's a great thing. And Australia is one of the few places in the world, really, where there's still enough freedom and still enough bush to be able to freely light a campfire if you're not stupid with it. And I guess that really comes into a lot of the songs that I write on this album. You know, there is a sort of a reference to the campfire all the time. It's where we get together. It's probably the first bar, really. You know, now we get together around a bar sometimes, but there's nothing more leveling, as I said, than the campfire.
What am I doing here on the banks of the Diamantina, where only skinny dingoes and horny lizards go? The moon is loud and clear, like the notes on my concertina. I'll play another droving song the white owl wouldn't know. 40 years been droving, no woman by my side. No one gives me orders on this dusty road I ride. But the sun can sure get angry as it burns you from the ground. One day those skinny dingoes can drag my bones around. Channel country, Gibber Plains, tablelands I know. And then there's gentle sand dunes where little mallees grow. There's a friendly campfire everywhere I go. I'll play another droving song the white owl wouldn't know. 40 years been droving, no woman by my side. No one gives me orders on this dusty road I ride. But the sun can sure get angry as it burns you from the ground. One day those skinny dingoes can drag my bones around. Later, Birdsville, you're far too flash for me. While the beer was cold and yummy, from here it's Billy T. The mob is keen on moving, and that sounds good to me. Good feed, they reckon, southbound, we're heading for Marie. 40 years been droving, no woman by my side. No one gives me orders on this dusty road I ride. But the flies can drive you crazy and the wind can get you down. But you won't find me lingering or hanging around this town. Yeah, 40 years been droving, no woman by my side. No one gives me orders on this dusty road I ride. But the sun can sure get angry as it burns you from the ground. One day those skinny dingoes can drag my bones around. One day those skinny dingoes can drag my bones around.
Albert Namajira, our famous watercolourist, I think became known to me, it'd be 40 years ago when my mother and father went around with my youngest brother, went right around Australia in a combi van. This is when there was no bitumen. I don't know how they did it, really. And I remember they came back with an Albert Namajira nephew or one of the other Namajira or relatives of paintings. But I started to take notice of Namajira paintings and just how much he captured that with the wonderful ghost gums more than anything and the colours of the ranges around Alice. And it always stuck with me, and I've always collected prints and that I've found in junk shops around the place. Could never afford a real one, of course. And then when I, my first trip to Uluru, I was that excited to see Uluru. I had a lot of the song written before I even got there. I got to admit that Raining on the Rock, at that time I hadn't actually seen it, Rain on the Rock. I don't know what made me write Raining on the Rock, but I guess I wanted to write something a bit different about the rock. And I could see the kind of things that were Albert Namajira was. I could see the kind of things that Albert would have painted on the way there. And that's where that idea came from. So when Warren H. Williams rang me from Hermannsburg with the idea that I might record Raining on the Rock with him, well, that was just a dream come true. I always wanted to have an Aboriginal connection, but I never wanted to force it on them or you know, push myself into that situation. It came to me at last through Warren, and when it turned out that Warren is in fact Albert Namajira's great nephew, well, I thought, well, this is just unbelievable. And so then I got more into Albert again, started to read his story, read his tragedy, really. And Warren told me a bit more about him, told me that he was in fact a camel boy at one stage for a couple of people, finally for Rex Batterby, who taught him to paint. But it's an irony too that Warren actually played Albert Namajira in a movie when he was a young camel boy. So it all came together, and I eventually wrote the song I wanted to write with the combination of all the things I'd heard about Albert. He's one of my heroes.
They called him Camel Boy, but he was a man. He walked behind us with a billy. He tended the campfire and he made the tea, drowned in the colours we didn't see. And the ghost gum stand, gleaming white, showed him a paintbrush, he showed us the light. I apologise for the condescension, paid no attention to the pain of the camel boy. It's Namajira, he became the one we remember all alone. Under a huge sky with a gentle hand, painted the pictures of an ancient land. What fools we were, what did we mean? Dressed in white to meet the queen. Take down a picture, hang up a ghost gum, put up a landscape by the camel boy. Cause a majesty was in his eye, the sleeping lubra, the Yardas guy. I apologize for the condescension, paid no attention to the pain of the camel boy. And the ghost gum stand, gleaming white, showed him a paintbrush, he showed us the light. Drowned in the colours we didn't see, what a man was he, Albert the camel boy. Albert the camel boy, Namajira the camel boy.
I guess the journey for me, you know, when it comes to the Aboriginal culture in Australia, is the reason it's come about more than anything. I've always prided myself of presenting a 100% Australian show, and it's finally dawned on me that really, without including some Aboriginal culture or the Aboriginal influence, I'm not really doing that. You know, I think I'm denying, like I think most Australians do, deny our greatest heritage of all, and that's the Indigenous heritage. So that's another great reason why I'm so delighted to know Warren. You know, the little bits I'm going to learn in my lifetime are just scratching the surface, and really it's only the Western Aranda mob that I know. But he's the keeper of the stones which the mob calls Jarangas. And I haven't seen them, and I don't mind that I never will, because I'm not an initiated man for a start, and very few people are allowed to see the stones. But it's great that Warren's generation is keeping the secrets going, which is just one of many, of course. And Warren's come through a hell of a lot himself. He's been on the grog, been on the petrol, all those things that I guess young Aborigines, I think more than anything, through lack of self-esteem and lack of knowing what their future is, knowing what they're going to do with their lives. And it's great to see Warren has come out of that. And I like to think that him touring with me has given him the kind of exposure that he needs. And it's also exposed a lot of people to his talent. And it's spiraling into giving him a huge amount of confidence. And I think he'll be a great example to younger ones coming up behind him who want to get into music, and there's plenty of those, and to sing their own song, sing about their own country, and even get into singing, recording a lot more language songs. I'd like to hear that and see that. So very proud to know Warren.
If you take me from my land, you leave me with no soul. I am like a tree. Everything I am is rooted in the soil, or I am just a stick to burn. I see you, my brother, in your desert shining, with your hand of gentle welcome. And you're looking for my sense of humor, I wonder how you do it, carrying a heavy load. And I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. The truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day. I see it in your knuckles, I see it in your eyes. You have been as low as you can go. It makes me happy, brother, to see how well you're traveling. You've risen from the ashes, yeah. And I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. The truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day. Soon you'll be a poppy, standing on your own. They'll try to bring you down when you're tall. But you have the power given in the stones. Your victory belongs to us all. And I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. Truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day. Yeah, I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. The truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day.
And Warren's always backstage working on songs, you know, I've encouraged that, and he's I think he's becoming very prolific. And I could hear this lovely melody that he tells me he got from some chordal structure from some symphony orchestra, which is pretty incredible. And I hear these lovely words about there's a child, and I thought, gee, that sounds fantastic. And I don't normally do it because I don't want to encroach on his writing, just like I don't like people encroaching on mine. But I said to him, that sounds fantastic. And I started to sing it with him and harmonising. And I said, gee, it'd be nice if I had a verse to sing. And I left it with him for a few weeks, but nothing came about. So eventually I wrote a second verse for myself and worked on the chorus with him. And I just think it's a great lullaby. It really has those pictures of being out there on our in the country, Central Australian country, anywhere, really out in the centre. And whilst it's, I guess, the images of black kids around the campfire listening to their own story, you know, and I guess a song encourages them to listen to their own story, carry on that culture. But I think it'll work as a lullaby for any kid around the campfire.
Sun goes down in the evening west. Now you can see nature's best. Red and gold in their full. Now you can feel even cool. Desert child, lay down your head and listen to what's being said. The stars are out in their majesty. Out here everyone is free. There's a child, lay down your head and listen to your song. There's a child, lay down your head and listen to your song.
Hear the crows, back they come to spend the night in the river gum. Soon the owl will softly glide. She'll better run and hide.
Close your eyes, the fire is low. We're all here for you, you know. My mom sings a lullaby. Baby, don't you cry. There's a child, lay down your head, listen to your song. There's a child, lay down your head, listen to your song. Listen to your song. There's a child, lay down your head and listen to your song. There's a child, lay down your head and listen to your song. There's a child, lay down your head and listen to your song.
We had a night off in Rena Springs, the crew and I, while we're doing a tour through the territory. And I reckon it's one of the last of the real roadhouses, really nice people running it. And lots of truckies parked there. And we had a campfire, they allowed us to light a campfire. So it was a bit of one of those evenings where I was contemplating my career. And I guess I was wondering just how much longer I'm going to be doing this. I mean, at times you do get a bit sick of being away from home. So it's really, that's what the song is about, you know, am I going to keep doing this? And there was a 30-foot windmill in the background squeaking away, so that came into it. But generally it's just really about, am I going to keep doing it?
Sipping beer and thinking things, the deepest thoughts that fire brings. Is it all that I can do, or will this be the last time? Snoring truckies, windmill sings, lonely sounds at Renner Springs. Round and round the road I go, the everlasting traveling show. Old guitar, a brand new crew, another song of missing you, another roadhouse black with one, keeping my eyelids open. I'll see Catherine on my way, she is on my mind today. Round and round the road I go, the everlasting traveling show. Taking the bad with the good, it evens out okay. I don't count the blessings when I should, I am well ahead, touch wood. Taking the good with the bad, shoot me if I moan. Round and round the road I go, the everlasting traveling show. Only a few turn up tonight, I'll get my mind around all right. I'll give them a show they won't forget, and they'll remind me one day. Remember you signed an autograph, a piece of paper torn in half. One for my dad and one for me, testing out my memory. Taking the bad with the good, it evens out okay. I don't count the blessings when I should, I am well ahead, touch wood. Taking the good with the bad, shoot me if I moan. Round and round the road I go, the everlasting traveling show. Sipping beer and thinking things, the deepest thoughts the fire brings. Is it all that I can do, or will this be the last time? Snoring truckies, windmill sings, lonely sounds of Renner Springs. Round and round the road I go, the everlasting traveling show. Round and round the road I go. Everlasting traveling show.
Yeah, well, it was last year sometime. I really thought it was high time I approached Slim for the first time to see if he would sing with me, you know. And I wrote this song that I reckon would really suit Slim. It was about us having a go at each other, about never giving up. And you know, it's all history now. Of course, Slim got very ill and he'd virtually agreed to do it, but he could barely finish his own album that was already working on. So, and then I thought of Chad, and I thought, in a lot of ways, Chad was actually more inspirational to me than anybody, because he was into comedy, and I think in a lot of ways, Chad is probably the most Australian of all our pioneers. You know, he's still around, so he's a living pioneer. And I was given an album of Chad's, The Sheik of Scrubby Creek, when I was about 19. Absolutely loved it. So, it now turns out that it was almost meant to happen. I recorded the balladeer with Chad, and he's firing on all fours. Chad, there's no doubt about it. He's singing as well as he ever did. He's full of life, and it was a great privilege to get in the studio with Chad. So it's a dream come true.
Will you ever stop singing, Chad, old mate? You think you might retire? Lie right back in Grandpa's chair in front of the open fire.
No way, mate.
When you reached the 70s, Chad, I thought that might be it. You're just like a young bloke champing at the bit.
Yeah, I feel like a 20-year-old. Two or three, actually. I'll never retire, John, old mate. The stage I'll never leave. I'll push out another song, old mate, as long as I can breathe. As long as there's a sunrise, I'll always tune me throat. As long as a fish are biting, mate, I'll never leave the boat.
Ah, that's what it's like to be a country balladeer. It'll never up and leave you lonely. There's nothing new about it, it's like old Uluru. So don't you go changing, mate, I'll thump you if you do. Your turn, Jen.
You think you'll drop the guitar, John? Leave it in the case. Head into the hills and disappear without a trace. If you reach 100 albums, mate, they'll tell you that's enough.
Yeah.
No, you'll be just the same as me, and I don't give a stuff.
You've hit the nail on the head, Chad. You got me to a T. I'm part of the guitar and it's a part of me. No matter where I go, Chad, I've got it in the ute. Call me one track minded, I don't give a hoot.
Lucky you didn't say track.
That's what it's like to be a country balladeer. It'll never up and leave you lonely. There's nothing new about it, it's like old Uluru. So don't you go changing, mate, I'll thump you if you do. Ah, that's what it's like to be a country balladeer. It'll never up and leave you lonely. There's nothing new about it, it's like old Uluru. So don't you go changing, mate, I'll thump you if you do.
If you change, John, I'll flog you with a wet guano. We got through the song then.
Yeah, well, after the tragic fires in Canberra, I was invited and asked to perform at a benefit concert in Canberra for the firestorm victims. And it was in fact the same night that This Is Your Life turned up for Deeks, because he lost his house, you know. And I didn't know about it when I was there either. It all sort of happened. But while I was sitting down after my performance, a young fiery came up to me in tears, and he said, it was obvious just how he was affected by the fire and what he'd seen lost and the kangaroos he'd seen burnt and all that sort of thing. And he suggested I write something, so I don't feel bad about writing this song at all. In fact, I think when he finally hears that song, he'll be quite proud to remember that he suggested it. But I think what inspired me more than anything was that really incredible documentary. And I can't remember what channel, but there was a journalist who actually went with the fire chief, and they were driving through it when it was at its peak, and it was middle of the day and it was dark, and the fireballs were just falling down from everywhere, and I'd never seen anything like that in my life.
I've seen a burning, never seen it higher. If you haven't seen a firestorm, you haven't seen a fire. Saw him running down the street with no home to go. Just the shoes on their feet, nothing else to show. I've seen hard times, as far as I can tell. But I hadn't seen a firestorm, so I hadn't seen hell. Saw the courage of the fireys, what they're trained to do. The But you can't beat a firestorm, no matter who. Saw a neighbor with a green hose and a trembling hand, cursing the thing he loves, this dry, dry land. I've seen a burning, never seen it higher. If you haven't seen a firestorm, you haven't seen a fire. So I'm crawling up a log, no place to hide. Saw a mother with a joey before they died. Day went into night, wind and rain from hell, and it told us who we love. Guess it's just as well. So I'm running down the street with no home to go, just the shoes on their feet, nothing else to show.
I felt very proud to be asked by the Prime Minister, John Howard, to join him and Simon Crean to fly across to Bali with the Air Force, you know, and for the first memorial service of the disaster, of course, the bomb in Bali. And I was asked to sing Waltzing Matilda. It all came after the way that we'd used Waltzing Matilda for the rugby and the Olympics, and I also feel pretty proud that I've helped bring that song back into prominence, because I've always believed it is our number one song. But I must admit, I was a bit of a doubting Thomas as the ceremony was going on, how Waltzing Matilda was going to fit. It just seemed like almost lighthearted for such a strong occasion or such an emotional occasion. But as it turned out, it really did feel, I guess there was more tears when I was singing Waltzing Matilda than any other time. I could see it, and it was very hard for me to perform it. But a lot of people agreed afterwards that it really did feel like I was singing the spirit's home.
To hear your voice, to see your smile, to sit and talk to you a while, to be together the same old way, that would be our greatest wish today. To hear you laugh, to hear you cry, or just a chance to say goodbye, to say the things we didn't say, that would be our greatest wish today. But all we can do is throw a flower on the water, look for the sun through the rain, lay a little frangipani gentle on the water, remember how we loved you. To comb your hair, to lace your shoes, buy some flowers, let you choose, a phone call when you're away, just to see if you're okay. To hear your voice, to see your smile, to sit and talk to you a while, to be together the same old way, that would be our greatest wish today. All we can do is throw a flower on the water, look for the sun through the rain, lay a little frangipani gentle on the water, Remember how we loved you. Remember how we loved you. All we can do is throw a flower on the water. Look for the sun through the rain. Lay a little frangipani gentle on the water. Remember how we loved you. Remember how we loved you.
But all we can do is throw a flower.
Remember how we loved you.
Look for the sun through the rain.
Remember how we loved you.
But all we can do is throw a flower on the water. Remember how we loved you. Remember how we loved you.